Short Stories of Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah. Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah was born on Friday, the 2nd November 1877, at 5:30 p.m. in Honeymoon Lodge, Karachi. In the beginning of February 1878, when he was about 3 months old, he suffered from pneumonia. The doctor was called, but the illness was intact. Lady Alisha, the mother, had taken him to Dr. A.R. Dugan, who examined and prescribed medicine and told her that there was no hope of his recovery, rather his survival. She alone came in the garden Jamaat Khana, where Imam Hasan Ali Shah was attending the Mehmanis. She stood behind the Imam's chair. When the Imam completed, she came in front and began to weep profusely and implored pray for his grandson, who would survive no longer. The Imam said, "You are a mother. If you want recovery of your son, then come here for 7 days. Sweep and wash the floor of the Jamaat Khana. I pray that my grandson will be quite well." Lady Alisha daily came from the honeymoon lodge to garden Jamaat Khana and swept, washed the floor and stairs. With the force of her services, her son recovered health on the 7th day. In the middle of 1878, Lady Alisha came to Bombay and stayed in the bungalow of the Agha Hall. The service of cleaning the Jamaat Khana had so impressed that she swept and washed the Hasanabad Jamaat Khana. One can judge her dedication in such service with the fact that she did not use the broom but swept with her long hairs and then washed with rose water. On 14th January 1926, some pressmen waited for Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah on the ground floor of Pune Jamaat Khana. When the Imam was on first floor, he came down and found that his mother was cleaning the stair with her hairs. Imam slowly made his way to come down without disturbing his mother, and by the way his legs touched her hairs, he came down and discussed with the pressman. Curiously, one pressman published in Gujarati newspaper, Bombay Samachar, that when Agha Khan visits Jamaat Khana, the Khoja women spread their hairs on the ground on which their Imam walks. The exaggeration of the pressman gave a cheap device to the rival camp to defame the Ismailis. It appears that such false rumors still is being hatched among them.